Hi beauties, welcome to Annie's Makeup Art. How are you guys doing? So, oh my God, I am so excited. Today we are going to explore and play with Pat McGrath's Divine Rose 1 palette. I have done something different. I added a lot of tips and tricks from my viewers so you can learn how to get this halo eyes and cat eye effect. So definitely watch this video to the end. This is a stunning palette by Pat McGrath, and I think the color story is so beautiful. You can do everyday look from this palette, and also you can make a dramatic makeup look. Using shade Valoria all over my crease line, a little above my crease line, and just blend it and make sure it's diffused all over your crease area. I'm going for shade Stain Mahogany on my outer corners and using rougher brush 28. I'm going to pack it as much as I can. So once it's sitting on my outer corner, I can diffuse it in V motions and making it a little higher to give a lift to my eyes. By diffusing the shade higher, it will also give my eyes cat eye effect, what I'm trying to go for. We're trying to achieve like a halo eye look, so I'm going into my inner corners using the same rougher brush 28 and also the extreme mahogany right by my inner corners, not all the way in. So I picked Skin Show Nude shade for my middle of my eyelid area. This will give a beautiful bright and wider look to my eyelids and also will make my halo eye effect just perfect. Going towards the next step, which is applying the Stila black eyeliner. I'm creating a very thin line from the middle of my eyelid area and just making sure it's not too thick and going towards making a beautiful wing and keeping it up so it will make my eyes give the cat eye and the halo effects we are trying to achieve. Using Pat McGrath's Superstar mascara. This is a gorgeous mascara and it just lifts my eyelashes so dramatically. The eyeliner on my waterline will make my eyes look brighter and whiter. I've been using Tatcha primer for the longest time now. It sits on your pore, make them look blur, and also make your texture look invisible. Get your skin ready for a beautiful makeup application. McGrath Sublime Perfection Foundation is so lightweight, and I think it's just perfect for the especially summertime. So I'm focusing on my middle area. I am spreading it with a brush, and then later I'm gonna use a beauty blender and make sure it just sits on my face properly. So to hide my dark circles, I'm using Charlotte Tilbury's Magic Vanish color corrector. This is like a medium shade because I don't have like really dark circles, but I do have some. So I'm patting with my finger. You can see the difference between both eyes. It just magic. My dark circles are gone. I'm gonna use Pat McGrath's Sublime Perfection concealer to brighten up my eyes. So I'm putting on the corners of my eyes by the waterline and also on the edges, and this will give me just the right amount of coverage and right on my high end area too on my nose. Now I'm blending it with my sponge, just making sure it spreads and gives me the full coverage. For contouring my face, I'm using Danessa Marek's contouring balm. What I'm doing here is I'm trying to give a shadow effect on my face, making my round face look a little thinner. I am also putting on my forehead, which will make my forehead look a little smaller. Using Patrick Ta cream blush, I'm going to apply it right on top of my cheekbones and make it a little higher, and this will just give me the perfect sun-kissed glow and also lift my face a little up. To set my under eyes, I'm using Pat McGrath's Sublime Perfection Blurring Powder. Guys, this product will do exactly what it says. It blurs your under eyes, and using the translucent color, it will just brighten up your eye area.
To brighten my high points, I'm using Danessa Myrick's Lightwork 1 Face Palette. It has beautiful shades, but today I'm using the color name like Duh. Yeah, literally, name is like Duh. And this is a beautiful brightening color, and it will just give you the right amount of shine.
Adding my blush by applying Patrick Ta's powder blush on top of the cream blush I have used earlier. We are almost done with all the powder products. I am going to apply Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Bronzer on the same spot where I applied Danessa Myrick's Contouring Balm. This will give my face the lift I was trying to achieve earlier, and also contouring my nose with same bronzer. Now that we are almost done with our makeup, I'm going to pull my Divine Rose 1 palette again, and I'm gonna take the Extreme Mahogany shade, and I'm gonna smoke up my under eye area and just blend it and pull it up a little bit to achieve the cat eye effect we've been trying to get throughout this whole video. Brighten up my eyes, I'm using Skin Show Nude on my waterline. Merge all your makeup products together on your face. Use a good buffing brush and apply the setting powder all around your face. Finishing up today's look with this gorgeous Pat McGrath's lipstick color Dream Lover. Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Setting Spray is just perfect to hold your makeup all day. Voila! Here is the final look. Oh my God, isn't it stunning? And I hope you guys were able to pick up some tip and tricks from me. And you should be able to apply on a daily makeup application, or you're getting ready for an event. And do subscribe to my channel, do like my video, and let me know what else you guys like to see next.
Take care and see you guys soon. Bye now.